Hello, I'm Jeremy with Equipment Technologies, and today we're going to talk about maintaining and adjusting your 100-foot Pommier booms. The boom sway adjustment is important because it allows the booms to move up and down the appropriate amount in the field while spraying. We don't want the booms to be too stiff, causing damage to the boom, nor do we want them too loose so they hit the ground. We will make this adjustment to the boom wear pad using 1 1/8 inch and 1 1/16 inch. The wear pads are located on the back rack. There are two on each side. We will adjust the gap between the steel tube and the wear pad to a credit card thickness using this adjusting bolt. First thing we'll do is loosen the lock nuts on each side. Next, we will adjust the set nut to get the appropriate amount of gap. Once the gap is set, we will tighten the lock nut. The bottom gap is now set. Next, we will have to do the top and the other side. Once we adjust the wear pads, we'll need to manually move the boom up and down to make sure we have the appropriate amount of sway. The boom sway is now adjusted. Let's move on to the next step. The next adjustment is for the boom lead. This is how far forward or back the booms are in relationship to the machine. This adjustment is made at the boom fold cylinders. Before adjusting the boom lead, we must drain the oil out of the boom fold cylinder accumulators. This is located at the port on the boom manifold block here. We will attach a hose to it and it will drain the oil out of the accumulators. So all we have to do is remove the cap on the port and attach the drain hose. Once we tighten the hose, the oil will relieve out of the accumulator. Once the oil is drained out, we will remove the hose and replace the cap. After determining how much movement we need of the boom, we can make that adjustment at the boom fold cylinder. We will first loosen the lock nut. Make the adjustment to the cylinder. Once the adjustment is complete, we will tighten the lock nut. Once the adjustment is made to the left side, we can move to the right side and do the same thing. We can now sight down the boom tube to verify that it is straight with the machine. The next step is to make sure the inner and outer booms are level and straight with each other at the hinge point. The first step in doing this is to make sure all of the ball joint bolts are tight. If adjustment is needed to level the inner and outer boom, the first step is to loosen the turnbuckle. Loosen the turnbuckle until the joint is relaxed. We can now raise or lower the outer boom wing with these ball joints, top one and the bottom one. We can lengthen the top one and shorten the bottom one to lower the outer boom. After the boom is level, we need to make sure that the boom is straight. To straighten the inner and outer boom, we do that by the two front bolts. First thing that we'll do is loosen the jam nut and then adjust the bolt. Now we can adjust the bolt to make sure that the booms are straight. Once the booms are straight, we can tighten the jam nuts. The top bolt is important to have a 2 millimeter gap between the bolt and the inner boom. Then we can tighten the jam nut. Once the inner and outer booms are level and straight, we need to retighten the turnbuckle until we remove the 2 millimeter gap between the top bolt and the inner boom. Once the gap is removed, we need to continue to tighten the turnbuckle to put a little resistance or a little force on the cylinder. That will ensure that the inner and outer sections are tight. Once we're done tightening the turnbuckle, we need to tighten the jam nuts. Now the booms are level, straight, and tight. The next adjustment is to check the tension of the brake back spring. We do this by loosening the spring first and then readjusting to 4 inches of a stretched spring. Once the spring is fully relaxed, we need to measure the spring and then re-tighten the bolt until we get 4 inches of stretch. Now we have the 4 inches of stretch on the spring and our brake back is fully adjusted. The last step is to grease the entire boom. There are 8 grease cirques on each boom wing, 1 at the breakaway. There are also 7 grease points at the hinge. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. There are also 2 grease points on each fold cylinder, here and here. Thank you for watching, and for other information, please consult your operator's manual or contact your Apache dealer.